Hi everyone, welcome here, and today I'm going to review and also show you how to program this gimbal. So it's a gimbal from Tarot, and sorry I already unboxed it. And inside the box we get another pouch of accessories. So let's open it. And this is the user manual. It's half English, half Chinese, and it's a USB programmer kit. I mean, this will connect to your gimbal, and here is a micro USB port through which you can connect this gimbal to your computer and you can program it. And it's a receiver controller cable. This 3-wire connector is a SBUS connector if you are using a SBUS connection, and if you are using a PWM connection, then you can use this as a channel 1 to control your roll or pitch, and this one is the channel 2. Again, you can assign it as a roll or pitch. And this one is the cable for video output. Yes, it's an analog video output. So if you want to use this video output cable, then in this gimbal here you need to connect this video input cable. But unfortunately there are no cable for this port, so I think you need to make this cable by yourself. It's an extra cable and I don't know what's the use of this. And it's a mounting bracket for mounting your action camera. Actually, this gimbal is a GoPro type action cam gimbal. And the best part of this gimbal is you don't need to do any kind of balancing after mounting your action camera. You just place your action camera over here and then you're ready to go. And this one is the power cable for power up the gimbal, and it support up to 14 volt. That's mean 4S LiPo. So for powering up this gimbal, I am going to connect a JST connector over here. And this one is the mounting bracket for the gimbal. Now here you can see I already mounted the gimbal in my drone, and the action camera is also placed the action cam mount. Now just connect this gimbal with my computer. So now we need to connect RC controller cable to this port and this USB connector to this port. Here I am going to control this gimbal through flight controller. So here I am not going to use the SBUS connection. Here I will use PWM connection. That's why I am using this receiver for test purpose. So let's plug it. Now jump to the computer. So when you first open the application, the interface will be in Chinese language. So what you have to do, just go to this language tab and change the language from Chinese to English. Now it says to reboot the application. So let's reboot the application. Now you can see the interface is in English language. Now you have to select the COM port, but unfortunately there is no COM port list. So I have to replace the COM port list, and now it's showing COM port 5. So I'm selecting COM port 5 and then connect. Now it's connected. You can see it, the gimbal status is stopped, and at the left bottom corner it says connected. Right now it is in FPV mode, and the channel 1 is tilt and the channel 2 is pan. And the pan and tilt also working with my transmitter. Right now the connection type is convention because I am using PWM connection. That's why I can't change the mode. It's stuck in FPV mode. Because in PWM connection, we can't use more than 2 channels. That's why I can't change the mode. So if you select the SBUS connection, then you can change the mode via your transmitter. Out of the box, it also support FRSky SBUS connection. Here I don't want this FPV mode, I want pan following mode. That's why I am changing it to pan follow mode. Now I need to flash this gimbal with this setting. So we have to click this right flash option. Now it's showing the parameter save OK. So now click the disconnect tab and disconnect the gimbal from the computer. Let's power it on, and don't worry, its boot sequence is little bit weird. So now it's 100% ready to capture some stable footage, and here you can see it follows the transmitter stick movement. And now it also stable the footage. No matter which direction your drone is tilting, it's always stable your footage. So thanks for watching.